Hello, scientific writers. In today's video, we're going to talk about the Orcid ID. What is it? What does it do for you as a researcher? And should you have one? Let's get started. Hi guys, this is Brian from Grants and Publications. Let's start off with the definition of an Orcid ID. Orcid stands for Open Researcher and Contributor ID. What is the Orcid organization? It is a global nonprofit organization. It's funded by more than 1,200 member organizations. And these member organizations include entities like universities, research organizations, publishers, funding agencies, and professional associations. So they pay into the Orcid organization so that the Orcid organization can do what they need to do at no cost to individual researchers. So individual researchers can get their own Orcid ID for free. Right now, more than 12.5 million people already have an Orcid ID. I have one. Do you have one? If you don't, I'm going to tell you why you probably should get one as soon as possible. So why is that? Why should you get an Orcid ID? The main purpose of having the Orcid ID is to distinguish you from other people. So other people might have the same name as you. I know I'm not the only Brian Waters who publishes in the scientific literature. If you search my name on Google Scholar or Web of Science or Scopus, you're going to come up with other Brian Waters who have published papers that are not me. But if you search with my Orcid ID, you're only going to find my papers. So it's a good way to distinguish you from other people with the same name. Another reason you should get an Orcid ID is that it is now required for applying to NIH for funding for research training, fellowships, educations, and career development awards. So you have to submit your Orcid ID on the paperwork as you're submitting your application. Additionally, there are now more than 7,000 journals that are using the Orcid ID. And as you submit your paper, they're going to ask for the Orcid ID for each individual author. Now, in my experience with a lot of journals, you can leave that blank if you don't have an Orcid ID, but you should enter your Orcid ID there because then the journal is going to automatically sync that record with your Orcid account. The same thing with funding agencies. When you submit a grant proposal and you submit your Orcid ID along with that, they will automatically sync your account. So it keeps it up to date and you don't have to do that manually. All right, so now we're looking at the Orcid website. This is where you would view your account if you already have one, or where you would sign up if you don't have an account. So if you want to see what Orcid says in their own words about what they do, their vision, their mission, and some definitions about the Orcid ID and the Orcid record, you can take a look at this webpage. So if you need to sign up, just go to here for researchers and register for your Orcid ID. Click that button. Once you do that, it's going to ask you for some information. You see that there are three steps: your personal information, then security and notifications, and you'll set your visibility settings. This is really a simple form. I'm not going to go through all the steps because you can easily figure out how to register for the Orcid ID. But what I'd like to show you now is what it looks like after you have established your account. So I'm going to sign in. All right, so now I am signed into my Orcid account. And what we see up the top here is I have my Orcid ID. So what you can do is take this number and you can put it on your CV, you can put it on your LinkedIn profile, or wherever you want to. And so if anyone wants to see your Orcid account, if you have it set for public viewing, they can just go to that link and see your account. This is what my Orcid record looks like. I have employment, and I haven't completely filled this out, but I have my most recent academic employment. I have my education section. You can fill in invited positions and distinctions if you wish to do that. Membership and service. You can enter any funding that you have received, and that's pretty simple to do. So I have a couple of my previous grants here. I don't have all of my funding, but I just have two of the federal grants. For me, the most important part of it is the publication record. So you see my 37 publications here. Over here, you can see how I have my settings. Who can see this? I have it set for everyone. You can change the settings to only trusted parties, or you can keep it private. So that's what I see. If I want to look at what the public version looks like, I can go here and click View Public Version, and this is what the public version looks like. So I have my settings so that everyone can see everything. So it basically looks the same, it's just a little bit more reader friendly. One thing I forgot to mention on the previous screen, you can also enter your other IDs if you use those. So the researcher ID, I have my Scopus author ID, and my loop profile. All right, I hope that was helpful. I would suggest that you get your Orcid ID right away and start using it. And the next time you submit a paper or a grant proposal, enter your Orcid ID to automatically sync your account. If you got value from this video, please hit the like button and consider subscribing to the Grants and Publications YouTube channel if you would like to see more videos on scientific writing related topics. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time, and happy writing.